but don't tell no lie about me, and I won't tell truths about you.
Shoo! 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 Shoo!
I'm out the way, I'm low, okay. Yeah, the island right here is remote, okay. I ain't thinking about no reaper. Nigga, I'm
reaping what we I back. So okay. Got a episode six. And, all in my house. And before we go any further, let's talk about K-Dot wiping the floor with Drake. Since we can play it, let's play it.
Master Bruce, Chief Hulk, D-Bone, G-Rack, niggas here, feet the man, they can cry, have the lane, tell the people, bro, nothing.
So what'd you think about that? Not like a song. Just the start of it.
That's gonna be the song of the summer.
Like, it's raps, right?
Easily.
It's raps.
It's gonna be the song of the summer. Everybody dancing to it, everybody making videos to it. And he beat Drake at his own game, really.
Facts. I was like, bro, the memes, the verses, the saying stuff about him that, but it's like, you can see it on camera.
Yeah.
It's like, you can speculate, because he even puts Drake and did so much on camera.
Too like, much. Bro,
come too on much. Now. But, yeah, I've been listening to that song every day. Talking about when I get in the car, I'm just when I get in the gym, I'm just
listening. It's the vibe you need. You set the mood.
Yup. When I'm cooking, I'm listening to it. Man, when I'm editing videos, I'm listening to it. That's the number one song right now. Not like this. But I just, man, that line was insane. Sometimes you gotta pop out and show me.
That is the, yeah.
Certified boogie man. Oh my God.
Certified for sure.
Yeah. It's like, it's a reason why people wasn't coming for him. I was like, they must have knew something people didn't know. Because it was other people that they just walked away from him. You know what I mean? They was like, I'm not going to mess with that.
He is crazy. He is insane.
And when he broke down the lyrics, when he was like, he a fan. Mm-hmm.
That was supposed to be acronym for Freaky ass nigga, you a 69 guy. And he said it right after. I was like, oh my God, bro. He said so much in there.
Yeah.
That I think people missed because they were so shocked at the stuff he did say that they caught. Bruh.
I heard somewhere that they said it was like, when he said, stab this way, stab that way.
Mm-hmm.
It was kind of like the R. Kelly.
Oh my man. God.
Yeah.
Oh my God. I didn't know that part.
How true it is, I don't know, but
like a step in the name. Yeah. Oh my God.
Yeah, like you on that same. Yeah.
Oh, this man, don't mess with Kendrick, bro. Don't mess with him, bro. Sheesh.
He's psychotic.
Yeah. See, I didn't know that part, and that makes perfect sense.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Yeah. What you think, T? What you think about that? Because I'm seeing all this stuff, bro. Little kids talking about OV Ho. I don't hear that OV Ho song.
And God, older people, like grandmas are singing it.
Crazy.
But
the Lil Wayne concert, they was playing it.
They playing it.
And all the crowd singing it. There was this like a pool party. Everybody was singing it. I'm like, damn.
What's her name? Made it her walkout music for tennis. What's her name?
Oh, that's right.
The one I know you're talking about. Naomi
Osaka?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
The LA Dodgers was playing it.
The Clippers played it. Yeah.
I mean, the whole NBA playoffs, they've been playing that much.
This is the only thing, like, if Drake really didn't do nothing like that, and it's all just speculation, right? And my advice to Drake would be this, because he up for BET Awards and the most BET Awards, they saying he up for it. I would, if I really didn't do no crazy stuff like they said in them songs, I would have security, right? Like ex-Navy, ex-Marines and stuff, right? I would tell the BET Awards, I'm not coming unless I got enough for like 30 people. And I would have 4 people that's with me that everybody see, and the other 26, nobody see, they don't know who they are. You know what I mean? Because running to Turks and Caicos, like he said you was gonna do, made it look bad, bruh. Selling all your houses in America and all that, it just look bad. So
I was just gonna say that it don't look good, the stuff he doing right now.
Yeah.
He moved his family away.
Yeah, it's like,
I'm like, what is going on?
It sounds like you did something when you do, you know what I mean?
Yeah, like what is it done turned to now?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. It's kind of crazy.
Yeah.
It's kind of crazy.
You supposed to stand on business if you really ain't do nothing, bro. Mm-hmm.
We don't want to hear you say
nigga no more.
Oh, man.
He said, rapping like you're trying to free the slaves, you lost right there. Once you said that,
yeah,
you messed up, bro. This is America.
Yeah.
You was on that Canada stuff on that line.
And Drake had on the blackface. Bro, I was in the comments and I seen somebody trying to defend it and be like, oh, like he was doing like something, blah, 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 blah. And I'm just like, as a black person, no, I don't think you ever want to do like a blackface.
Hell no. Nah.
So it was just, it wasn't a good look.
At all. He made so many missteps. It's ridiculous. Like,
and the fans are scrambling. They trying to find anything that be
anything,
like,
yeah.
Oh no, it's not because of that. It's like, okay, well,
anything that'll help.
Yeah, bro. It's just not working.
I was just gonna say, that's what I was gonna bring up. My bad.
What's up?
So I kind of get Joe Budden now, why he let them two niggas go.
I know you've seen it too, huh?
You feel me?
They be flip flopping.
Rory and Mal. Now that Mal is cool with Drake,
mm-hmm.
he done flipped all the way around. Like he just. Like even
Drake
he was acting
no
like
wrong.
Yeah, even he was acting like, oh, Drake didn't lose or Kendrick Lamar got to come harder and this and then that. I'm like, bro, this dude. But Rory was like, what are you talking about?
Yeah.
Like you,
yeah,
what are you talking? I give it to him.
So big shout out to him because he told the truth.
But Mal just now, just because you friends with Drake, you just gonna say he can do no wrong. That's not. Come on, bro.
Dog. When I seen the one on his. On his show still, Ish? Is it Ish?
Yeah.
Like, come on, Ish. Come on, bro. Yeah, I thought you was a real one, bro. I really thought you was one of them real ones. I was going to be like, yeah, man. I was rooting for him, but he lost, bro. I thought you really... He over there making excuses like...
Yeah.
Like, it's nothing Drake could have done. Nah, bro. It's cool. He lost. Just be real, bro. You know what I mean? That's all.
When you hear Ish talk on the podcast... He's not a fan of Kendrick.
That's what I'm saying.
So it's at cool. that point, like you can't make a biased decision
or an
unbiased decision because you're already a fan of Drake and not Kendrick.
Facts. That's what, yeah.
I mean, shout out to you, to all of them, but I'm just saying, bro, I thought you was a real one, bro. Yeah. For real.
I mean, everybody was up dancing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Except for Ish.
You feel mm-hmm. me?
And the other one, he a Drake fan, but he's like, man.
That's what I'm saying. That's a real one, bro.
Yeah,
he's
like, hey.
That's a real one, bro.
He got beat, man. That just is what it is.
I just unbiased.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's my thing. Push-ups was good to me. I liked
it. The family matters
was good.
Yeah.
He just lost, bro. That's all. So, you know.
Because this is where he lost me. Is it Ish? It's because he, when it was like, he said that.
Uh-huh.
Like, he could have put anything out and he would have lost. But then it was like, when the other dude, Ice, was like, you know, I mean, to be real, that Family Matters would have been crusher to anybody else. Then he was like, yeah, that's true. It would have been a crusher to anybody. Like, you're flip-flopping trying to pick and choose what works for you.
It would have been
if
a crusher.
Kendrick didn't respond.
Yeah.
As fast as he did.
Exactly.
It probably would have worked out.
Yeah, it would have worked. Yep.
I agree with him on that.
I think Kendrick knew that.
Yeah.
Yep. If he let it sit, marinate on people's minds.
Something.
We got to crush
him. He would have won. Early. That's why for him to say, to come around and be like, oh, he would have lost no matter what. How you can't flip-flop. You just flip-flop.
Well, that's the fans.
See, yeah, you feel me?
This is what the fans doing. Like, they're saying it was a lose-lose situation. So they're saying like, oh, like, after all the stuff is being said, mm-hmm. no matter what, Drake was going to lose. So it don't matter how he responded.
Mm-hmm.
If he was like, oh, I didn't do these things, then it would be like, okay, yeah. Mm-hmm. And if you don't respond, it's like, ah, he didn't respond. But at the same time, it's like, it's the same with Kendrick.
Yep. Either way, it would have been with him.
So he didn't respond to stuff.
And people was trying to say stuff. And that's why it's like, okay, y'all say that, right? It's a lose-lose. But how did y'all feel when Family Matters dropped? Y'all was like, it's raps. It's over.
Then y'all was all sad. Y'all start hearing this song come on. I seen DJ Academics.
Academic face.
I seen your whole life crumble. Yeah. Even though you kept it real, though, you saying he lost now. Yeah. But yeah. I seen your whole look on your face change. All you heard was,
I see dead people. No, that was before. That was the one before, though.
Oh, yeah. The one before. Which one was that one?
Meet the Grams.
Yeah.
It changed the whole It changed the whole mood.
Meet the Grams did.
I see what was like, crazy. That's right? Why I like Joe Budden take on, because he was in rap battles. You feel me? He was in these beefs and stuff. So when he said
Joe Budden is unbiased, even though he's biased a little bit.
Mm-hmm. He'd be biased. He'd be biased on this.
You know what I mean? Because he don't like Drake.
Yeah.
But so he couldn't wait to be able to
and
do
and he loved Drake at the same time.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying?
For me, when he said what he said, like Drake dropped that a banger, it could have been a banger, and then he went and dropped the Alchemist beat that was just the tone, it changed everything.
Yeah.
And I get what he's saying. Like, don't let Drake run with this beat and everything, you feel me?
Academics was chop it off. Rolling though, because he was on the Flagrant show with Andrew Schultz, and he was like, man, he played chess with this dude. He was like, he played mental games with this dude. He was like, he came on like the dude from Saw talking to Drake.
Yeah.
I was like, damn.
Dang, DJ Academics said that?
Yeah, DJ Academics said he was doing all kind of mind games on this dude. And this only thing I don't like though, like, because he said, thankfully, Meek Mill was so dumb, he could just do him any kind of way. But he can't say that because the way that the fans was like back to back and riding on them, that's the same thing that's happening to Drake right now.
Yeah.
But people trying to make excuses. Don't treat him like you did Drake, or like y'all treated Meek Mill. Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like, don't switch because Drake was contacting you and sending you the song or sending you a heads up that he about to drop.
That man Meek wasn't
ready.
That man Meek wasn't ready.
Yeah. You know what I mean? So
and he came back with the Undertaker beat on the thing. I was like, he about to kill him, and he just did it.
I could tell the way he was rapping to Meek.
Yeah.
He didn't even really want to do that.
Yeah, he wasn't even in the right.
I could tell the way he was. I could tell he just didn't want to do that. He just was doing it. That's what it seemed like. When I first heard that, I was like, man, he rapping like he really don't want to rap on this mug. He really don't want to be in this battle.
That's what I don't like about, come on, bro. I understand. I get it.
That's
but Meek Mill, you don't got to keep on talking, call him a dumb.
That's what I'm saying, bro. Leave Meek Mill alone.
Like, that's the little beef they got.
Yeah. It's like, let's not do that, bro. Let's leave it alone.
But that's what he was doing. He was like, everybody just ready to see Drake lose. And then he was like, because when Drake took 2 weeks to drop, if Kendrick taking 2 weeks, they act like, oh, no, just wait. It's coming. He take a minute. But when Drake takes too long, he was like, everybody's like, see, he don't want it. He's scared. It's like, nah, bro. That's what I was saying about the Meek Mill and Drake situation.
Drake was the one that set the timer, though. Hey, I waited 4 days.
Yep.
Where you at, Meek? And now that it was the same thing, it was like, oh, no, it's different.
Exactly.
In beef, like Tove and Nas. Mm-hmm. Yes, it was back then, but it was like months in between.
Yeah.
It was so different. It's like, you don't have to respond that next day.
Mm-mm.
You can respond when you want to respond.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
But with Drake, he was like, I'm going to drop charged up, and then I'm going to drop back to back.
Yeah.
Now, I'm applying the pressure because I dropped 2 records, and you haven't dropped one yet. Even though you're on tour, blah, 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 and all this kind of stuff.
Man.
It don't matter. You got to respond now. So Drake set the timer, and when it was used against him.
Now it's changed.
Yep, exactly. Yeah. Everybody changing the goalposts.
Yeah.
Nah, it got to be the same across the board. If this how it is, it's how it is. You know what I mean? That's all.
And it's like this too, because everybody, everybody pick and choose what for you. Okay, so let me ask y'all, because everybody got different things that they put in categories for, like, for a rap beef. For you, what is it in a rap beef that makes a clear winner? Because if it's a rap beef, it's called a rap beef. Mm-hmm. You're supposed to be able to rap. Right?
Yeah.
So I don't understand why people...
It's coming down to the records.
Everybody would be like, no, I mean, but if you do... Yeah, you see what I'm saying? It come down to the... But a lot of people be doing some... I don't know. It's just a lot of flip-flop stuff. And like you said, maybe it's just a whole bunch of the Drake fans just it's flip-flopping.
Drake fans that know that don't know about rap beef.
Because that's what it is.
Their whole thing was that, oh, everything that he was saying is not true. First of all, we don't know. And second of all, if it's not true, it's still two lives better in a rap beat.
Yeah.
So,
you got to insult the person.
Yeah.
Right.
And he just insulted you with the worst thing he can insult you with.
And that's what I'm saying, though. But not only that, it was proof.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. It's video. You gave him everything he needed.
So it's hard.
By being the person you are, that's why it's kind of, it's kind of hard for me to be like, it's fake. When
he didn't have to pay for none of that information.
No.
Yeah.
He was just there.
He was just there.
Everybody's seen
it's been there for years and nobody said nothing about it until now.
Certified lover boy, certified, you know what? You feel me?
Wop, 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 wop.
Fuck him up.
Oh my God. That's crazy. Yeah, because for me, man, I'm like, y'all, everybody's trying. If you don't really know, I get you, you're right about that. People that don't know what rap beef is, because for me, it's like, you're supposed to insult the other person. That's what they do.
I'm just saying. What has Kendrick Lamar done on camera that you could have said, and it's been nothing, because he don't do nothing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He stay out the way. He try not to. He just make music. You know what I mean? It's like Drake was so out there and open with all the stuff he was doing.
He had a horrible commercial too. I don't know if that was a commercial.
The Nike one?
Which one?
When he was a young kid, like
Drake?
Yeah. It was black and white.
I'm surprised they let him still be in a Nike commercial, dog. Like,
oh, it just came out.
I was like, oh, they put that. Oh, then they got the Drake. I was like, no.
As a teacher.
No. Why?
I was like, hey.
Why did y'all do
that? As a high school teacher, it's crazy.
Nike messed up right there, bro.
As a high school teacher, I was like, that is crazy.
Whoever's on the marketing team, oh my, y'all messed up, bro.
I'll be honest. A lot of people around him, he needs to readjust. The ones that let you put that line in, if I was to mess with a little girl, I'd already been arrested.
Yeah, that was a misstep.
Who told
he made a bunch of missteps.
Who told you that, bro?
He lost it for sure.
Why? Who is telling you to do this stuff?
Yeah.
I'm be honest. He really should have listened to Joe Budden. Joe Budden was telling him the right things to do.
I'm gonna be real. Once you said he rapping like he trying to free the slaves,
yeah, that
you lost me right there. Cause I was like, wait, hold up. That was supposed to be an insult. I was tripping. I was like, hold up. He was trying to insult him with that? Like, you know what they have going on in America? Bruh, stop, bruh.
But he don't know.
That's why you need a real one in your studio.
Bro.
Instead of a yes man. Because, bruh, I would have told you, Drake, I might whoop your ass in the studio for saying that, bruh. For real. I might whoop your ass right now for saying that.
I want to
take that stuff out, bro.
I want to know how many people thought that was a cold line. That's a Drake fan.
His whole team,
man, bro.
All his fans think it was hard.
That was terrible.
Because listen, if you look at all the comments everywhere, that's what they saying. Like, don't nobody want to hear Kendrick. He trying to be an activist, all that kind of stuff. And it's like Drake don't ever rap about that kind of stuff.
Nope,
nah.
And that's fine. You don't have to.
Yeah.
But that's the difference between the two.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's what Kendrick is trying to show y'all. That's what that's what he's rapping about. He's not
really for the culture.
Nah.
He just uses it.
And to gain his.
And that's why not like us hit so much hard on that third verse, because all I was thinking about, he did say he rapping like he trying to free the slave, trying to get the slaves free. I'm like, hold up. Oh yeah. It made it that much more.
It hit it harder.
Poignant, I'll say. You know what I mean?
And if to be real, I mean, what he said on it, was it not true? I mean,
it's 100% facts.
Yeah, everything he said on that mug, he had to go to Atlanta to get those type of stuff.
Yeah.
So I'm like, yeah, it's crazy.
Facts.
I mean,
he had to give a Future. He had to give a 21.
He had to.
Yeah.
The Migos.
Migos. Before that, Fetty Wap.
Mm-hmm.
You know what he
That's
was.
That's what I'm saying.
That's New York, but.
Yeah, then, but still, that was like.
Waves.
Let's throw one more in there that everybody didn't talk about.
What?
Kurt Cobain.
Took his whole stuff. I've been saying this for years, though. I was like, hold up. He took the way he dressed and everything. Like, mm-hmm. like everything. The whole Houston slowed down. Mm-hmm. Like, chopped and screwed. Mm-hmm. Everything. He did everything this dude was doing. And Kurt Cobain was bigger than him at first. Because mm-hmm. he had dropped that, you know.
Drinking My Cup.
Drinking My Cup. That shit was, he was going crazy. And then Drake came a little bit after that and just took this dude whole style.
And then when you said it and I went, and now I'll be like, I listened to Kurt Cobain stuff.
Yeah.
Then when you go back, I was like, dog, everything.
Yeah.
The Houston, Atlanta, Vegas song.
That's what I'm saying.
All them songs was all, like, that was a.
That's Kurt Cobain style, bro. He just took it. He started wearing jeans and stuff like this dude.
Yeah.
Everything. Started dressing like from Texas with like, the boots and.
That's right.
He started dressing like he really was from Texas. I'm like, how you from Canada and you from Texas? You know what I mean? That's what I was tripping off on years ago. I was like, I like Drake songs, but it's like, I could clearly hear. And then, but
that's messed
go
up.
Listen to that new Kurt Cobain's album. I'm telling you.
Oh, yeah, it's fire.
I'm telling you. That new one is hard.
It's actually good. Yeah, it's actually good.
I've been bumping that in Young Blue and... Oh, Kendrick.
The best to me though, the best those are the best
Bryson Tiller
R&B one. Yeah, Bryson Tiller and his one called Ryan Trey.
Ryan Trey good.
Yeah.
I gotta go listen to it. I ain't heard that one.
You heard it. I did. When we was driving down there. You was like,
oh, yeah,
hey,
yeah.
We didn't skip nothing. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's those albums right there is some cold R&B albums. If y'all looking for R&B.
Yeah.
Young Blue, Bryson Tiller, Kurt Cobain's, and
it's
Ryan
just Blue
Trey.
Now, ain't it? It's just blue.
Is it blue?
Blue.
I think
yeah,
so. Yeah,
blue,
that's right. Yeah. Blue. So those ones, man. Yeah. If you're looking for some R&B ones to ride to, because I'm going to be real with you, all I listen to is Not Like Us every time. The whole two-hour workout is Not Like Us.
Trying to see Compton.
Yeah.
Oh, that's my stuff right there. I ain't gonna lie.
I've been there for 2 hours, bro. Yeah. That's the only song I've got it on repeat. And then when I go to the sauna, I'll switch over to Ryan Trey.
I'll switch over to Kurt Cobain's album.
Yep.
I listen to it while I'm working out the whole just that song the whole time.
Right.
I was listening to all the other ones before that one dropped. As soon as that one dropped, that's the only one I listen to now. I even was listening to the push-ups. And Family Matters, but I don't even listen to them no more.
You know how hyped you'll get now? Do you know how many football teams is going to be playing this before?
Oh my God. Bro.
This is going to, like, it's not
going to. I can't wait for the bands to start going crazy with it.
College football about to be crazy for sure.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be crazy.
It's man,
gonna
be crazy. I'm trying to go to a game just to see the band play this mug. Yeah, I'm going to be real with you.
It's like, this thing though, I was a fan of both. So
I'm a fan. I was a fan of Drake too.
Now,
I mean, I like his song still.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll kind of feel bad and then I kind of be like, I don't know now. I gotta see what's going on.
Yeah.
I gotta see what's up.
Yep.
But because I think he need to go ahead and switch the title though, because you can't say Summer Vibes on
because
this whole summer gonna be Not Like Us.
Yeah.
So you need to just switch the title, come up with something different. But every song gonna have to be
It's gonna have to be ridiculous. Every song. That's why I don't try to do no 20 song album. You need to do this. Is what you need to do, bro. Go in the lab, get every writer you can find, everyone, and make every song a classic. And only put like 12 to 15 songs on it.
That's the problem, though. How many writers you think he got?
Lil Yachty can still write for you.
Yeah, Lil Yachty
can help you write a hit.
And
I don't know who else.
And who party? Yeah,
you know what I mean.
But I mean,
he stole all his music.
Damn, he did.
I'm like, bro.
Like I'm saying, like how so?
And you're going to have to find some new writers that's hungry.
But how many people going to want to work with him after they done find out? Oh, Daylight came out and said that he didn't do what he said he was going to do.
True.
They'll still do it though, huh?
If you're doing that, that ain't cool. You're supposed to look out for them.
Yeah, you're supposed to look out for them.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Especially if they write you a hit. You see what I'm saying?
Even if they don't though.
Yeah.
If they're writing for you for a whole album.
I think he the one that wrote Back to Back.
Yeah, he wrote Back to Back.
Yeah. So.
It's like, bruh.
Yeah.
If you're doing stuff like that, I see why everybody don't like you. If you really telling them you about to help them and they don't.
Yeah, speaking of not liking somebody, I wasn't gonna bring it up. I didn't want to talk about it personally.
I know.
Oh, no, go ahead. We got to.
We seen the video.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Sean P. Diddy Combs.
Brother Love. Take that
crazy shit
away, bro.
It's funny.
Where's
though?
The fucking love?
That's funny because remember I told you when a person try to go overboard like that,
yep.
It's all about love. You messed up on something. You know something about
it's like
out.
The girl that be like, oh, I'm all in the church. Mm. It's like you was out like, here, what? You was out here going crazy.
That. Let me not say that.
You was out here going crazy for a while. Now you gotta, now you know, I found
you bored
God.
Again. You bored again.
You know, all that kind of stuff.
You bored again.
So yeah, we see the video.
Yeah.
And bruh, I was like,
the first thing I thought was, damn, our shit was 110% right on this nigga. I didn't know he was doing this. This is what he did when he thought nobody was watching.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? So just imagine what he was doing with people contracts, like he said. Just imagine. Whoa. That's something less.
Even let's do it like this. He might have held back a little bit just because she was out by the elevators and he knew it was cameras.
Exactly.
Out there. So when he got her back in the room, what did he do to her?
Exactly.
If he was brave enough to do that.
No, what's crazy is that he knew there was cameras. He still did it and he was like,
I'll just pay him.
Wow.
$50,000 all they take.
He paid him to get
yeah, to get
he
rid
had
of
to.
Wow.
It's been what?
But now
8 years?
Yeah, now he can't get arrested for it, they saying. So that's why the tapes came out.
He can't. Wow.
I guess
it was 2016, I think, when that was like, bro, 8 years ago, and they didn't even. That's insane.
That's kind of crazy to me that you could still get caught on camera like that, but because it's 8 years later, it's all good now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's crazy to me.
He was beating the brakes off her like she was a dude.
That's what I'm saying. He was stomping her and kicking. I'm like, bro, what is wrong with this dude, bro? She's not even fighting you back. Or
I'm talking
she
about
just laying
the littlest woman. She not even. I ain't even saying it was ever right, but I'm just saying. You see how little she was.
I see why J. Cole was whooping your ass.
Yep.
J. Cole probably all these people probably was like,
put them paws on you.
Oh, you hitting women like that? So now I'm gonna put these dogs on you. What I see?
You not finna Drake me?
That's crazy.
Nah.
That's crazy.
Yes, wild.
You see the video he put out too?
Oh, yeah, that just came out today?
What did he put out?
Like he's
an apology or something like that.
Yeah, an apology video.
I didn't listen to it. I don't know.
Yeah, I didn't. You listen to it?
I'm like 50 Cent. So this is why 50 Cent was going so hard. Because remember, people were like, man, 50 Cent a bully.
Yeah.
This is why he went so hard.
He'd be right. Mm-hmm. Yeah. 50 Cent be right, though.
He ain't been wrong yet, bro. So shout out to you, 50, for being the only one that stand on business with people that supposed to be something. You know what I mean? The people scared of because right, he didn't stood on business with everybody. Yeah. So
he was calling Hov out though.
Yeah,
he said Hov next.
Yeah,
I'm like, please.
A bunch of people been saying,
"Wait, 50 Cent?"
I said, "Please."
A few people been done saying,
"Please, please,
man,
don't have nothing."
But you gotta think about it too. In the 90s, in those times, mm-hmm. It was different. It wasn't no cameras and stuff like that.
I'm talking about the last 24 years.
You think something happened in the last 24
years? I don't know. The way 50 Cent talking.
He talking.
Damn, bruh.
I just hope it ain't nothing.
I mean, I don't put it past nobody.
But 444? Come on, man. That's my album.
I know.
Damn. I like Jay-Z songs too, but. I mean, there's some artists I like that I can't listen to no more.
Damn.
I used to listen to their songs all the time when I was a kid. Can't listen to it the same no more.
It's not that difficult, though, to not play Ignition, though. Like,
No. I'm talking about that R album.
You know?
That our album was
ridiculous. See, I don't go that far back with him. I don't go that far back.
The only reason is because Nick, when I was like 7 and 8, I was listening to every song on that album, word for word, bar for bar. I knew everything.
Which is crazy.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Like, bruh. That's how good it was.
It's good.
But it's like, it's good. I can't listen to it the same.
I mean,
like,
I don't listen to it no more like that. Yeah.
Because when you remember the titles to certain songs, and you like, it's kind of like these Drake songs.
I'm glad you brought it kind of full circle back.
Yes, it's weird.
People now is going back and listening to the lyrics.
That's what I'm saying. Songs. You listen to the lyrics.
Academics though is doing. I'm like, damn, Academics, you switched all the way up for real. Because Academics is even listening like, oh, that didn't age well. And he's skipping. I'm like,
yeah, because it make you like cringe a little bit. It's like, hold up,
because it's not sounding right.
Yeah.
And then you got these pictures come out, and you got these videos come out, and you be like, hold up.
Then you Millie Bobby Brown stuff.
But he had one line in one of these songs that I just barely heard, where he was like, "I'm glad I waited to get it." I was like, "Whoa, what?"
I know. Did he just say? He didn't say. And when you first listen to it, you don't be catching them.
Yeah.
But now that Kendrick did this, it's like stuff jumping out at you.
I'm like, what the heck?
And you be like, hold up.
This dude just said.
But you know what? It's certain songs I never listened to from Drake.
Yeah, that's
those songs I never listened to.
Yep.
Because I don't like them songs. They don't sound good to me. But like the Drake songs I listened to was like the Fake Love one, because that song was hard to me.
I listen to R&B Drake. I don't listen to rapping Drake.
Yeah.
See, I listen to rapping Drake.
And see, people don't like, some people say they don't like the singing Drake. They want the rap. Like, I'm be real. I like more the singing though. I can listen to the rapping.
I like both, but.
But what's his name make it seem like, I don't even know why I'm.
It depends on the song.
The Breakfast DJ Envy, he the one that was like, yeah, I like the rapping Drake. Drake be rapping. I'm like,
I don't know about that. I ain't gonna say he be rapping.
Yeah, I don't
he
know
be having
that.
Some clever lines sometimes.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? That I'd be like, oh, that was catchy. Oh yeah, that was good.
I'm
that
like,
was a
he's
bar.
Not barred up like that. I don't know what you're talking about. So
he's not like this. He's not like this. Oh my god, that line right there.
That one.
You gotta pop out and show me. I'm the one up the scope.
Woo!
I'm telling you, bro. It's don't y'all better not never say Drake won anything when it comes to this battle. He's certified got stepped on. I'm just be real.
And I still didn't like that. I still don't like the fake ass response thing that he put at the end of it. Like, it was a good, nice little rumble. Nice
I'll come back when you start telling the truth.
I'm like,
why are you running in?
No facts. Yeah.
Man, that's real. I don't know. I just like, and this thing, though, I'm not a Drake hater at all.
I'm not either.
I like the stuff, but damn, bro.
I like hating on Drake a little bit. I'm not gonna lie. Like, I like the music, but I do like there's certain people that you just enjoy hating on because so many people are just like,
yeah, I feel you.
They could do no wrong.
Yeah, I feel you. Yeah. They're that's treating real. Drake like that. Like Drake, they were saying he was underdog. I was like, no, they was making it seem like Drake was winning
that
already.
When he lost,
they was like, he was underdog.
Crazy.
But at first they was like, he don't want to see Drake. Blah 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 blah. You know,
and even that's what excuses. I'm saying. And even Drake, see, you messed up when you said he, you basically was like, Boogeyman who? Then he's flipped that, you said a long time ago, and he flipped it in this.
And that's what I'm saying.
Certified Boogeyman. I'm like, dog, y'all don't be, it's a.
You
it's,
fortunate you stopped because I thought that line that you flipped, I was like, oh, he flipped that. Kendrick, even I was like, remember, I was like, Drake flipped that? He flipped what's a prince to a king? He his son, nigga. That was the hardest shit you could have said. Yeah. But when Kendrick came back and was able to flip, because he could have flipped, like you said, you were saying, he could flip that Michael Jackson stuff some more.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Into
you
more.
Better be glad you stopped. You better be glad you stopped, bro.
Absolutely.
I forgot he could have flipped it into a lot more now.
I'm like, bro.
Damn. So, you know. That's crazy. That's why I don't know, but me and you said this before. We said this is the only person he really don't want to go with because this is the one person that's that big that can, it could mess it up a little bit. I ain't saying you're never going to be who you was, but
But look what it's doing. I'm just saying. It's gonna take a Nike talk to them about they might back away from him.
Yeah.
All these companies talking about they gonna back away.
You're gonna take a big hit.
It's a big loss. And 400 million, just 450 million just for Nike.
Yeah.
The NBA talking about backing up all of them.
Yeah. Nigga. He might not be able to be a Toronto ambassador up in there for basketball because it's like, bruh. You it's bad now.
Them nigga trash anyways.
Yeah, I how many people gonna start dogging over the court now?
Crazy.
They was letting them win all the time. Uh-huh. Cause I swear you let them win. You if you go play basketball against Drake, you letting them win. Not even trying. Like, come on, bro. So that's why I'm like, how many people done let him win? Now with this happening, how many people gonna be dogging him? And he gonna be like, man, what happened?
Yeah.
So
crazy.
We're gonna see. It's like I was trying to figure out how I guess 50 Cent though, kinda, cause at first when West Ham dropped the Family Matters and stuff, they was like, 50 Cent was like, man,
he dropped the bomb.
Yeah, it was a bomb.
But then
the video, music video and everything.
Yeah.
That shit was a grenade.
Compared to what Kendrick did.
Whoa. That was a Claymore or something like that.
Oh,
but
man,
then I was like, 50 Cent never really, he put out never really put out nothing when Kendrick Lamar drops the stuff he drops.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, okay.
Yeah, I know.
Which is kind of weird.
Yeah.
But guess what? Guess what?
I'll try to figure
out. I'm hearing that, well, they put out there that it's going to be a remix to Not Like Us and Snoop Dogg going to be on it. A bunch of West Coast artists and then Dr. Dre going to remix be a part of the beat. Yeah.
I don't need Snoop on there.
That's what I'm saying. I don't need it if they're going to do it. This by itself, it's good, bro. It's classic.
If I'm thinking West now.
I think they said the West Coast now.
Because I wouldn't do
Roddy Rich.
I think he doing, I don't know if he's on a remix or if he's doing something with Kendrick. Something new. So
I know what you mean. It's like Roddy now, Rich and Rihanna. Not nobody.
Roddy.
With Kendrick.
Ooh, if Rihanna gets.
Simba. Yeah. Maybe YG. I don't know.
I don't think YG.
I know
he
friends with.
Yeah, he cool with Drake.
With Drake, I don't know.
AI Nipsey, you know, a little.
That'd be crazy.
Little AI Nipsey on there.
That'd be crazy. So Rihanna's supposed to be on that one?
No. I'm just saying she's working with him.
Yeah, she's working with him.
Oh, for the album.
Yeah.
I'll take that.
Because I remember that song on he did do with it was classic, the love song. Yeah, on Damn. I love it. That's one of my favorite songs of all time.
Well, it's going to be what it's going to be, bro. We're going to see what happens after it all. Because I'm like, now when it's all said and done, we're going to see. We got to see what happened when he dropped the album. We got to see how that's
going
to do now.
Well, you know Kendrick's going number one.
Yeah.
Once he drop an album.
And the crazy thing is he's supposed to drop this month. And I'm like, so now is he waiting?
I think he was waiting because these songs are doing so good.
Yeah.
It's doing better than the album.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? It's like, this is an album by itself.
So.
These four or five songs.
Yeah, it is.
You know what I mean?
I mean, they 6 minutes long and stuff too.
Like they talking about 2 and 3 beat changes.
Yeah. So what do you say? When y'all think he dropping? I think he gonna wait till Drake drop and then he gonna drop the right in a couple hours after.
I think closer to summer.
He was supposed to drop in May, right?
Yeah.
He'll probably drop next month.
For sure.
He'll probably drop next month.
I'm thinking so.
Cause now he got pretty much everything in hand with him.
Yeah.
Yeah, so as soon as he dropped that, you know everybody going to get that.
So he could wait till August if he wanted to.
To be real, yeah. Cause this song gonna go all summer. Yeah, y'all right. That song gonna go all summer. So he could wait. That's real. But this thing, I'm trying to see, is he more like on that tip where he like, is he gonna let Drake eat? Because Drake gonna try to put it out in the summer because he always try to put it out in the summer, get some fans over the summer.
Or it depends on what Drake say.
Yes, yeah. You know, he's still gonna probably.
If you still trying to like sneak this, all right.
And that's what I'm saying. Drake, don't try to sneak this. Please don't. Because you lost already.
I mean, not him anyway. Like, if you wanna, Ross or somebody.
Yeah.
Do what you do.
Yeah. Do not come for King Dot, because you might get more of this. You like young. dog, stop. Please stop.
I was sitting there all morning today. Oh my goodness.
Bruh.
Out of nowhere.
It's not worth it, bruh.
Out of nowhere.
Man.
Oh my goodness. That is terrible.
Yeah, bruh.
Yeah,
that's all you gonna get. You gonna get pieced up again. Like, stop, bruh. He pieced you up, you move on, take your lick and move on, bruh.
That's the crazy thing too, is we used to Drake having them liners that everybody wanna repeat.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This mug got lines.
When he said, is it your girl tour? Is it your world tour? Your girl tour?
Yeah.
Man, we remember that.
Yep.
But it's like,
but this one,
that was fucked up.
Yeah.
This Not Like Us got like, in hell, every verse got,
there's something classic.
Multiple lines that you repeat. Yeah. Crazy.
He a fan, he a fan, he a fan. Oh my God.
Crazy. Crazy, bro. So, man, we'll see. I mean, the crazy thing is that we got three albums coming out this year. That's
which ones?
Is J. Cole supposed to drop this year?
Yeah, J. Cole dropped.
That's what I'm saying. J. Cole.
He said he was, yeah.
Kendrick.
Kendrick.
And Drake.
And Drake, yeah.
So we got the...
They still technically the big three.
To me, I don't care. I understand what y'all say.
Yeah.
Just losing don't make you... It's just not... It's just we know who the top dog is.
Yeah, we know who the top dog is.
Now we know who number one.
Yeah, exactly. We know who number one now. Yeah. Now y'all can put who you want to put two and three.
Now...
You know what I mean?
Now, if Cole and Kendrick go at it in a friendly way, how he was trying to be with Drake.
Yeah,
he said it could have been cool.
Yeah.
If they want to go at it now, then I'll be cool with that.
J. Cole.
He wouldn't do this to him.
Stop.
Yeah.
Please don't play with this. Nobody should play with this man ever again. I'm just being real, bruh. Don't play with this man. It's different. You didn't even know what he was going to do. Yeah. All you heard was, psh, I see dead people. I didn't even think he was going that way. You see what I'm saying? Made a classic bop to an old, that's the freaking that Ether movie. Beat, bro. And then that movie.
Yep,
bro, don't play with him, bro.
Yeah. But don't I see what him, you're bro. Saying. But see, what I would want instead of that, I would want that album that everybody been waiting for. We've been wanting the J.
That's
Cole,
what I
Kendrick.
Want. You need together. To be doing joint album with him.
It's been
don't
10
try
years.
To go with this,
it's
man.
It's been
bro.
10 years. I don't know.
Don't know if you really want it now.
No, bro. Like, I would still take it, but I'm, I just don't know how it would be now.
But I see what you're saying, though. I mean, they could just be like, we're going to keep it friendly. Just yeah. take shots. We just going to, you know what I mean?
You sure?
They got to let it be known. Like, they got to.
I ain't going to push it again.
They got to come out.
Party took a, he took a shot.
He took a shot. That was.
Do my stuff. Ain't you tired? Probably A minor. Bruh.
That was.
Play with him if you want. Yeah. Play with him if you want, bruh.
You know. I know what you're saying, though. But I would come out and be like, we can. It's really bad.
You have to. You gotta let everybody know, like, hey, yeah. this is. We're cool.
Yeah.
We're just going to rap together.
We just going to do a little rap out. We not out here trying to do nothing like that.
We're not about to hurt you
know
nobody.
I mean, then everybody will still accept it. Because they be like, oh, yeah, that's cool. I want to see them go at each other like
yeah.
that. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that'll be cool. But ain't nothing like that.
They not like us. They not like us.
They not like us.
They not like us.
The hook
they
is hard.
They
used to say he don't make good hooks.
I'm for real. This is probably the, one of the coldest hooks he's
bruh.
Ever. It was on. He was in the pocket. I can't even say he just.
Yeah.
He was in the pocket on this beat. And DJ Mustard.
Yeah, bruh. I don't know what Drake did. Or maybe one day they'll say, well, damn.
Yeah. Damn. I think people don't realize, though, that even though the West Coast, when it comes to rapping, they might get into it with each other. But when they go against other people, like from different, exactly. The West Coast gonna have your back. That's the day I think people don't realize. And Drake probably thought, well, I'm big enough, I'm gonna have them too. Nah.
Except Game, you know.
I lean on them like another line of walkie. All eyes on me, I'ma send it up to Pac. Don't play with this man, bruh. Please.
Yeah. I know, that's the Game. He the only one that's going to try to stick up for Drake. But it's because, you know, Drake messed with him and he hit, you know. So, I get it. Man, but bro. When it comes down to it, the rest of the West Coast is going to be like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For sure.
You know? Yeah. I'm like, how many more songs do he got with DJ Mustard coming on his album? That'll be at least two. That'll be
good. He for two. Sure going to have Metro. Mustard.
Oh yeah.
I guess he got somebody Dr.
say. I heard somebody say that that Kendrick didn't win because because the beat was a leftover from YG album. And I was like, I don't give a fuck where the beat came from. I don't care where the beat came from. The shit went.
He put his foot on your man's neck, bruh. And Bird, oh my. Go see right there. He said he can go further. I'm telling you, he was gonna go further with them Michael Jackson lines, bruh. I'm telling you, bruh.
Should he be worried about that one line though?
Which one?
You think the Bay gonna let you disrespect Pac?
Yeah. I wouldn't even go there no more. I wouldn't even go there no more. Because it's just in it. If he said that, it's probably because he knows something. I mean, they probably are offended by it.
Yes, yeah.
He didn't go?
Yeah.
He didn't go.
I wouldn't go to that much.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
I would cancel every show in the Bay Area.
Don't go back there.
It's different out there. They don't really play
about
their people. They serious. Yeah. That's what I'm saying, though. Like you was just saying, the West Coast, with certain people, they don't play about them. And that's one they not finna play about.
Yeah. You know especially what I mean? The ones that's still
but
out
see,
there
Drake is from Canada, so he don't really know.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
There's hoods in Canada, guys.
Yeah, but
that's what everybody was saying in the comments.
The West Coast is like different in America. Like,
and that's
West
why
Coast, if they ride for
that's
you,
that's why he made
they're
that
going to ride for you till the wheels fall off. That's what I like about the West Coast, though. They gonna ride, bro.
Mm-hmm. They sure is. And that's what he's saying, not like us. He's saying y'all the whole spot not like us. Yeah, y'all got hood too, but it ain't like what we be doing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So I get what it's like, bro.
Crazy, bro.
But I mean, like I said, I just want to see what's gonna be. I mean, we kind of lightweight see it now, but I want to see like the whole fall, like how it's gonna play out now.
Yeah.
Cause I'm like, you gonna have to.
It needs to be over, bro.
It's gonna be hard for you to shake the other stuff. So to be honest with you, I wouldn't even take no shots at nobody on this album. I'm just making hits. Cause
that's what he needs to
that's
do.
That's the only way you're gonna probably be able to get out of that. And I say probably, because we just don't know still. We don't know what else gonna. It's a whole bunch of stuff keep popping up out of nowhere. I'm like,
I feel like his team is not good because
they not helping at all.
All that happened was y'all tried to get some of these women. It seemed like he paid them to come out and say Drake didn't do nothing.
I know that's they ate it worse right there.
Sell every house in America, then move his people to his wife and his baby mama and his son to Paris or something. He go to Turks and Caicos where he said he was gonna go to. Like everything is backwards to me. Like I wouldn't have did none of that. Even if I was gonna sell the houses though, I wouldn't be running to Turks and Caicos and running to all these spots. I'd be like, bruh. I mean, I don't know how serious all that stuff is though. So it's like, bruh. It just looks weird.
It just looks bad.
You know what
I mean? I'm like, man, it looked like you're getting ready for something to come out or something.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
That's what it seemed like. It's let me set up shop in these other countries.
Let me sell all my houses in the U.S. and stuff. Like, why? What is going on? It's weird.
Like, you thinking they was coming to raid your spot. That's what it seemed like.
That's, yeah, I'm gonna be real. I don't know. But we, you know,
I don't want to get off before we get off topic. What is wrong with Diddy's son? What is wrong with this dude? You hear the lines he put in his, like, too bad they didn't raid the house next door. What the hell? Because we own that one too. They hit the wrong house, basically. Then he taking shots at 50 Cent. Come on, bro. You can't be that. You got the wrong team around you too. What's wrong with these people?
I didn't even know he said that.
Yeah, you didn't hear that?
I didn't even listen to it.
Bruh.
I didn't even listen to it. I don't want to hear what he got to say.
50 Cent posted.
50 Cent dude.
It was like, what's wrong with him? Yeah. He was like, I'm scared. He was like, I'm scared for my life. Sean Combs, his son threatened me. I was like, God damn, bro.
50 Cent, I'll be honest with y'all though. 50 Cent and Rick Ross is funny as hell.
Yeah.
They funny as hell on Instagram, bro. I'll be real. They be funny as fuck when they post stuff. I'll be cracking up. But yeah, I don't know what's up with that one. I don't even know. I didn't even look at it because I was like, I don't really care what he got to say. I don't even really like most of his songs.
So in conclusion to this Drake Kendrick stuff, Kendrick clearly won. Like, if you saying Drake won, you just either a meat writer or you just don't like Kendrick. You know what I mean?
And here's the thing. If it was a tie or if Drake would have won, I would have said.
Me too.
It was a tie.
I have no
Drake
picks.
Won. It would have been no picks, but
guess what? When he did that to Meek Mill, I said Drake won easily. Drake won clearly.
That was hands down. Yeah,
feel me?
Yeah, it was hands down. Yeah. But this one, you gotta just be real.
You gotta be a real one to understand.
This one, he destroyed him with that song. It's raps. He's losing Nike almost. He might lose Nike.
Yeah.
Who won?
Yeah.
All Kendrick did was gain a whole
Kendrick's
bunch.
Songs
of
songs is above his now.
Yeah.
He broke records. Drake records on all this. It's like, come on.
Duh. He went from Instagram followers. I think Kendrick only had like 4 million. And Drake had 165 million.
At the end of the day, the people decide who won. And the people are showing you who won by the streams. Because him faking streams, what's his name, Drake, still couldn't outbeat, his name, streams.
Yeah.
The most genius move this dude did was take the copyright stuff off of the. That's why I'm playing this mud. All through this mud. Drake could never. Is this your king? He could never. I'm just saying, bro. It's levels, and K Dot is just levels above him when it comes to rap. Now, popularity and all that—that's different. Drake had that. I don't know about now,
but what I'm saying. So yeah, no, I don't want to hear no underdog shit. 165 million followers on Instagram to 4 million. What are we talking about? It's not even close.
I thought Kendrick had 14.
No, it jumped up. I think it jumped up after he had. Okay. He might have 10.
Yeah,
and then it jumped to like 14.
I think he
This mug had 172 million.
But guess what?
It's like, bro.
When you be faking a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? People buying fake followers.
Yep.
And now you can check how many fake followers they done bought. Mm-hmm. You can see now. It's ways to actually check.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, that's a topic for another pod.
But yeah. So we done with that.
Yeah, we done with
on
that.
On to the next.
On to the next. So I seen that trade they tried to make to my team.
What was it, mock trade?
Yeah.
Like a mock, they said.
I don't want that bullshit. I do not want it. I don't want Tyler Herro. Keep his ass where he at. I'm like, dang, like we was getting a deal.
And who was y'all losing though? Oh,
I mean, we wasn't losing too many people. It's just Tyler Herro, I don't think fit with us if we got Shy, Jalen, our center, homegrown. I mean, Lou Dort is mainly there for defense, but he scores sometimes.
And that's what I'm saying. I know y'all lost.
It's some players we can get rid of though, but I don't want Tyler Herro for him. Like we could have been got rid of Giddy.
But let's stay there. Because last part we talked about this exact series. And somebody was very confident. I know. And I said what I said.
I know. I knew you was going to say that.
And I just had to.
That's why I was like, oh.
Oh, you did say that.
He going to make me let me hear it. Man, at least we not the Lakers, though. You know.
I said Mavs in 6 or 5.
I thought you said. Know.
You said the Mavs.
Yeah,
though,
he
huh?
said the Mavs.
Yeah.
Man. I thought he said 6.
The Mavs going to get washed the next round.
Can remember if he was like, he said 4-0.
Very possible. And that's fine.
They're going to get washed.
I didn't pick them for the next year.
They're going to get washed.
I didn't pick them for the next year.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah, you was right.
You called it's it. Cool. Man. I'm going to be real.
We ain't even had Bronny James on our team, so we good. Bronny James going to be a Laker.
He would have thrown the Lakers out there.
Bronny James going to be a Laker.
Very possible.
It could happen,
very
yeah.
Very possible.
And when we playing, we finna dog him.
I'm trying to see. From that series, though, what are y'all lacking?
Oh, on my team?
Yeah.
Leadership.
True. And then we need.
That's probably it.
Yeah.
I feel like it's some pieces that don't need to be on our team, like role play, some role players that can go, but
who?
I mean,
it's like bench players. Bro. I would want to keep Lou Dort,
mm-hmm.
but
that's 3-and-D guy. Okay.
I would keep.
You got Joe. You got.
I like Joe, but I would want to deal him. I would want to deal Giddy.
I think he's a free agent this
Giddy
offseason.
Is? Or Joe.
Isaiah Joe and Giddy, I think.
Damn. They should have traded that.
So now they can't trade them, huh?
I'm making through sign and trade.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. They can sign and trade. They might
but
end up doing
want
that.
Them?
Somebody picked them two up.
Yeah, people like picks.
Yeah. Because they could use them to get other pieces.
And that's what I want. I want to like a 2028 or 2027 pick. No, 2028, because I feel like somebody going to come by the 2028 draft. I feel like if somebody come. See, I would want Bryce James. You feel me?
Mm. But this is the thing.
When he graduate, but.
Next
or I would
year.
Want Carmelo's son.
I'm talking about.
Or I would want Carlos Boozer's son.
Oh, they come out this year, man? Next year, right?
Those are the type of players I want.
See, but if y'all. Team. See, but if that's the case, then y'all would have to be like a bad team at.
I know.
Yeah, not really. Y'all good. It's like, because y'all looking to get there again next year. Y'all
yeah, we could get there with
spot.
The same team we got right now. But yeah. Like, what would make
when
us.
When I
like
watch
step.
The game, for me, I feel like y'all need one more.
He right. We need a veteran, though.
Yeah, y'all do need a vet.
We need a veteran.
Y'all need a leader, somebody that can lead.
On like a Kyrie Irving type.
And, you know, I like Jay Williams and all them, but mm-hmm. they need somebody to be like, no, give me the ball. Let's do this.
Yeah,
Jay Williams sometimes
he holds
like
too
him,
long,
but he hold it so long, and then he make a decision sometimes that he shouldn't have made. Yeah, yeah.
You know why? Because he's a number one on another team in his eyes.
And
right now he's second because or third because of
he's third, the third option. He's supposed to be the third
check,
option, but that
but
coach,
he don't be.
What I don't like about that coach is
like
that he
rotation.
Let them just do whatever they want.
I don't like
and
his rotation either.
The game I watched, Shai was going off. He wasn't missing nothing.
Yeah.
He need to take them shots. You missing. Give him the ball.
Yeah.
He
and
held
Shai
the ball so long until he had to go ahead and put it up. And I'm like, dude, give him the ball. When he miss, this dude shot at one behind the backboard, make. You give him the ball at all times now when he's hitting like that.
Yeah, because he studied Kobe.
Jay Williams, he want to. That's the only thing I.
I'm telling you, in his
here.
Eyes, he is the number one.
Either you need a.
Is Chet number
veteran.
Two, though, on the team?
I feel like he the number two option when we play certain teams.
Certain
the
teams.
The matchups,
yeah.
You know what I mean? Because, like, if you go against Houston and Sin Gun, I feel like that's a good matchup for him when the player's not. Like
I like Sin Gun.
Yeah, Sin Gun is good. But, like, going against Joker. I wouldn't say he the second option is.
It's gonna be tough. Well, I mean, it was tough in this because thinking about Lively and all them, they just defensive
they
minded too.
Yeah.
Lively and all them, so they defensive, they can score, but they defense.
Man,
so it was tough for him this series. He was scoring.
What if we got another tall center?
And that's what I was saying. Gonna say I would go for somebody else.
An think actual y'all need, center, you mean?
Yeah. Because he's not really.
He's not a center.
Yeah, small forward.
Yeah. So if y'all get an actual center, I feel like that'd be good. But who? What center would y'all trade to go get?
Sin Gunn. That's who I would.
I would get him. But is they gonna give him up? I don't think they're gonna give him up.
You know who we probably can get? What's the one from Milwaukee? But
that's a veteran.
Yeah,
Brook Lopez. Get
him, but.
He's a straight center for sure. And he can hit threes. But he's getting rebounds. He's still able to get up and down court pretty good.
Who else is out there?
How old is Brook Lopez now?
That's what I'm saying.
He's like 45?
47, yeah.
He can't be 47.
He's not 45.
He's 37?
Or 38.
Because they was 2 years older than me. Because they was in, it was 1 year I was at.
They was only 2 years older?
Two or three.
36.
Oh, they only 1 year older than me.
That's crazy.
I'm 35.
So who else? Who else is out there? That's a veteran, but not too old, I guess. Do the center got to be a veteran, or can they get another veteran player? What you think?
They get another one.
They can get another one, but a center for sure, because I could see he was struggling with them
bigger
them Dallas ones.
Yeah,
it's like Houston got Van Vliet.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
And that kind of helped them out, I think, this year.
Yeah,
because he's.
I wonder if there's one out there that's not a liability on defense.
That's
Pat Bev.
And Pat Bev a liability on and off the court.
On offense,
man.
At the press conference,
yeah. Yeah, liability. Like,
I forgot he did that. Oh yeah, that's right. Yeah, it's a whole bunch of Clippers that's up. This year,
is Kawhi a free agent?
Nah,
but he wouldn't go.
What's his name is?
And they just signed
who?
Harden.
Man, I don't want Harden Westbrook.
Vets.
I don't want either one of them.
You want?
We tried
Westbrook back.
Nah.
I mean, what about Harden back?
Harden's big. We tried it.
But Harden can he play point guard now?
Nah.
And Shaq can be Shaq.
He make horrible decisions. I'm cool. He dribbled the ball too long, and
so y'all don't think if y'all would have had what's his name, y'all don't think y'all would have beat
Serge Ibaka.
I just don't want him.
Serge Ibaka.
Serge Ibaka.
Nah.
Bring him back. Kendrick Perkins.
He not even playing.
I don't know. I'm trying to see who would be because Rudy Gobert he's staying there now. That's the best fit.
I mean, the only one on that list was PJ Washington. I might take.
From Dallas?
He's staying in Dallas.
Oh, wait, not PJ Washington. Who was on that list? Not Washington. Is it Tucker? PJ Tucker?
PJ Tucker?
No, not PJ Tucker. Who was the one?
Is he a liability?
That's on, he's on Charlotte. Bridges. Was he on that
Bridges?
List?
Yeah, he's on that list.
That's the only one I'll probably take from that list.
So they got Jaime.
Oh, Jack, where's he a rookie? So I don't think he's a free agent.
And I'm be real, they's talking about. I would not want him. Got to see him play. He's not all that.
Jaime?
Yeah, he need a little bit more time.
No, he had UCLA. He all right.
Yeah, I'm cool on him.
It's his first year. What you mean?
He was getting destroyed in the playoffs. But he is his first year.
Yeah.
His first year. He gonna be just an average player though. Once it all come down to.
I mean, he was balling at first. Then he crumbled.
Yeah.
But like he said, rookie.
Duncan Robinson was.
They I definitely don't want him.
Dang, let me see who free agents coming up this year.
Tyler Herro is a free agent, or they trade? That's a trade.
They were just talking about trading. Yeah.
Yeah, I just don't want Tyler Herro.
Can I ask y'all? Is Tyler Herro like that threes? For y'all? Is he one of them players?
It depends on who you ask. I think. Like me, no, yeah. I wouldn't take him.
I wouldn't take him. Yeah,
but I just don't want him.
I don't know. I don't think 2020. It'll be 2024 or 2025. Free agent. 2024. Let me see.
I'll take that center from the Spurs.
Oh, top available ones they got right here. Oh, from the Spurs. Oh, Wimby. They not letting.
No, not Wimby.
Oh, okay.
It's another one on the team.
Collins.
One of them. That's the backup.
I think it's called. Well, I don't think he's a backup because I think he start, but.
Well, one of them, yeah, maybe it was. It is
like a forward, I think.
Because one of them be getting heck of rebounds.
So the eligible ones.
Free agent centers?
Yep. Oh, no, no, just free agents right here. Restricted free agent. Let me see. Unrestricted free agents. Oh, what's name is a free agent this year already?
Who?
Giannis Antetokounmpo. But he's signing back for sure.
We got Bismack Biyombo on my team, and he don't even play.
For real?
I'll see him on the bench, yeah.
Mo Bamba.
He was having a good time on the bench.
Damn.
No, for he was laughing and shit. I was like, bro.
We can trade him.
The hell going on?
Mo Bamba. Oh, Sadiq Bey from Atlanta. He a free agent this year.
Oh.
He was getting rebounds.
Nurk. Is Nurk a free agent?
Let me see. Bobo is.
Oh, Nurkic. He's from
Phoenix. That would be a good
Nick Claxton.
I think he'd say. I would say Nick Claxton would
Nick
be
Claxton
nice.
From Claxton? Brooklyn.
Oh, yeah, I'll take him.
He a free agent.
Yeah, I would take him for OKC. Yeah.
Yeah. Alec Burks. Nope.
Jared Allen is a free agent this year? Or no?
Let me see.
He just signed a deal, didn't he?
No, no, Jared Allen. I don't. Kyle Anderson.
Nah.
They got two-way ones on here.
Also UCLA, by the way.
Imani Bates for Cleveland. Bismack. Biyombo.
Oh,
he's on OKC. He just never played. Let's see. Oh, Miles Bridges is a free agent.
Mm-hmm.
I'll take him.
Jay Crowder, Robert Cummington, Spencer Dinwiddie.
Trash.
DeMar DeRozan. Let's see. Let me see who's.
DeMar DeRozan is a free agent?
Yeah.
I wouldn't take him, though.
Andre Drummond.
Who?
He don't show up every game.
He don't. Taj Gibson.
That nigga like 50.
He's still in the.
Yeah.
What?
He's still in there. Let's see. Man. Who is some? James Harden.
Hell no.
Clippers. He
Clippers need to sign him back.
Tobias Harris is gone. I know Philly ain't signing Tobias Harris back.
They better not bring that nigga back.
Yeah. Isaiah Hartenstein.
Hey, I might take Tobias Harris.
Nah, bro.
I might take him.
You know why? I know why you're saying that. Because
the pressure's off of him.
Y'all can still play.
Yeah.
Y'all start because he's not like a.
He's not a starter.
I need the ball in my hand. Saying?
So he's not starting then. He coming
no,
off
no,
the bench.
No, he can start.
He will start.
Yeah. He will start.
He will start over.
I feel you. He would start over one of them other ones. Like Isaiah Joe or Giddey.
Or Josh Giddey, because he was starting. Yeah,
Josh Giddey was starting.
So it'd be Shea.
Ooh.
Jalen Williams.
Yep.
Tobias, Chet, and then you need that.
Mm.
The other person.
He's a strong leader, though. I can say that.
Who?
Tobias Harris.
I won't take it. He ain't led nothing. That nigga shot twice, had 0 points in 29 minutes in the playoff game. That's crazy.
Yeah, that was bad.
That's what I'm saying. Y'all want that for real?
Nah, I'll take him though because he a big body.
But is he going to be able to play? He's older too. Is he going to be able to
How
play
old is he?
All these games?
He can't be no older than 29. I don't think.
Maybe not. And y'all had Gordon Hayward on the bench this whole time. I didn't even know.
No, he played
a little bit.
Oh, wow.
He just trashed.
Hurt like that. Isaiah Hartenstein.
See,
from
I would
York,
get rid of him, though. I would get rid of Gordon Hayward, too.
Hartenstein, the center from New York, but they probably going to sign him back.
I would take sure.
If they don't sign him back.
Tobias Harris is 31, so I was wrong.
He's 31?
He's 31.
I mean, that's not too old. He still can play.
Yeah. We'll see.
I wouldn't sign that nigga though.
Derrick Jones Jr.
He's staying in Dallas.
He's staying in Dallas.
There's certain people that's gonna stay in Dallas after this run.
DeAndre Jordan.
Oh, he had
DeAndre Jordan.
He had Denver,
he
but
Denver.
They
he
don't let
play.
Him go.
He don't even play.
Nah.
They're probably bringing him back just to be.
Oh, y'all can go get Superman come back.
Hell no.
No, there's some people that's just done now. Yep. So like Dwight's done.
Yeah.
DeMarcus Cousins is done.
Yeah, he done.
At
he
this point, they just, yeah. It's just,
yeah, that's real.
It's hard to not play for this long.
Kelly Oubre.
Or he playing in China, I think.
Cameron Payne. Hey, I'm trying to see if they got any, like, centers like that.
I would take Kelly Oubre.
Kelly Oubre?
Yeah, I'll bring him in.
Temple.
Kelly Oubre, yeah, that's a good
one. Obi Toppin.
I would trade LeBron for anybody, if I'm being honest. Yeah. Me personally,
to be real, you could trade LeBron for a gang of people.
Me personally, I would move LeBron.
Valanciunas is about to be a free agent.
I'll be real, I'm trading LeBron and AD and getting a whole new squad.
Bro, I'm starting from scratch.
Yep. Ooh, James Wiseman though for Detroit. The center. Right, man.
He traded. He decent though.
Yeah,
he
right?
Decent. He not. He good. Was better at.
Yeah, he not.
At Golden State, he didn't do nothing.
True.
That's true.
You had to show up.
Or Jonas Valanciunas for New Orleans.
He's free?
He free agent after this year.
Oh, like 40?
Yeah, he old now. He's older for sure.
He's not 40, bro.
Because he played on, when he first got picked up? Toronto, right?
Toronto for a long time.
For a long time. But yeah, y'all got some options. You got some options, bro.
Valanciunas is... Come on, dog. Oh, he 32. He got a little bit.
That's it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I thought he was way.
Listen,
over.
I'm gonna be honest. If niggas like Al Horford still playing,
yeah,
true.
And he hustling out there,
yeah.
I mean, these niggas do it. They can do it. Cause he out there moving.
So how y'all feel about these other series? What New York played today? This the game seven.
Game seven.
New York against Indiana.
I think New York finna get it, but I don't know.
Josh Hart is hurt, and I think that's gonna play a factor in the game.
Damn,
he's
hurt.
He's playing, but he's in pain, definitely
injured,
and you can like it shows. Mm-hmm. So I feel like it depends on Halliburton because he's been passing a lot. And I had him on my prize picks, and for some reason he don't want to shoot the ball.
He don't want to shoot.
Damn. So
this gonna probably be the game. He needs to.
You have to.
I think Josh Hart.
You have
for this game. You know he hurt.
Man,
for what?
For points. You got to get like
14 points, right?
Yeah. We'll see. I just took a chance on it.
Yeah, we're gonna have to see.
Because last game he was running around, but it was like, man.
You could tell.
It was bad.
Man. Yeah. Well, you can bet on women's basketball now. They say, I'm hitting it. I hit 3-4 times already on women's basketball. Shout out to you ladies in the WNBA. I rocks with you.
Yeah.
You dig?
Hey, I've been watching it. Yeah.
Oh, I forgot to tell y'all, though. Mm-hmm. The owner, the Raiders owner, he bought into the LV Aces, I think.
Las Vegas Aces.
Yeah.
Tom Brady?
No.
Okay, Tom Brady got Mike something Davis. In there, too.
Oh, for real?
I believe so.
Mike Davis.
Is it Mike Davis Jr.?
Al Davis.
Son.
They gave each player $100,000 extra on top of their salary. $100,000 piece because they said they dedicated to it now because they've sold out 15 of their 20 home games already. So, well, they just need five more.
It's Vegas, so they just showing up to...
True, Vegas everybody coming. Up. Yeah, everybody coming to that one. That's the spot. I was out there.
Yeah.
The football stadium is like you can see it. Yeah. And then the basketball stadium is like maybe a mile away or 2 miles away.
And the Aces is
Asia.
Got Asia Wilson.
Asia Wilson. Kelsey Plum.
Yeah.
It was a couple rookie suitors over there now.
I don't know why Derek Hamby not there no more. Why they traded her.
I don't know, but Derrick Henry,
she cold.
Was giving them the business yesterday.
Yeah. She helped me hit on every one I picked.
Yeah, she went off.
Shout out to you, girl. Shout out to you.
Yeah. Now they
I just be need one extra point. They don't give it to me.
Angel crazy. Reese helped me hit my mind too.
Yeah, Angel Reese got me. She got
Angel
me.
Reese.
She got
Caitlin
me.
Caitlin Clark. Derrick and Hamby, I've been hitting.
I mean,
those
I didn't pick Caden Clark, but I picked
Angel Reese.
Angel Reese been hitting for me with the rebounds, bro.
I had she man, I haven't missed yet.
I just been needing 12 points. That's it. I feel like she can get 12 easily.
She's at that Chi-Town Big Three. They they balling right now, right?
Yep. Izzy over there.
I'm be real with you.
I think her name is Isabella.
After watching this, I think I can already pick my
let me see how I'm doing right now.
MVP race.
Yeah.
Already, just off of looking at that. Asia Wilson.
Mm-hmm.
Rookie MVP?
No, just the MVP.
Oh, MVP.
Asia Wilson, Derrick and Hamby is going to be up there for this one for sure this year. Breanna Stewart, if she keep playing like she been playing these last couple games now, she been balling. She won last year already. But
the New York game on already. First quarter.
New York Knicks?
Yeah.
Damn.
Well, guess what? Ariel Atkins got 9 points. She needs seven
more. I was going to pick her.
Skylar Diggins need three more assists. She got three. Jewel Lloyd need three more rebounds. She got two.
Okay.
So I'll let y'all know if I win on that one.
Oh, yeah, yeah. WNBA.
Andrew Nembhard got two rebounds. He need one more. Dang, Jewel Lloyd got 13 points. I picked her to get less. She might pass that one. She got 13 points. She got to get 23. Mm-hmm. Then the other one.
That shit be coming fast, bro. I'm telling you.
Yeah.
I'll be watching. I'll be like, you wouldn't like this last game. Man. And that should be pissing me off.
It's all good, bro. It's
Obi Toppin has 0 points. Josh Hart got two.
And that's the problem I hate with Obi Toppin, because I'm like, dude, they traded you. Mm-hmm. And you was supposed to be something.
You
got to
go off over
go
this.
Off. Yeah, yeah, don't.
He don't even got a rebound, because I picked him another one. Boy, it's rebounds.
I mean, it's only the first quarter, though, right?
Well, he's standing in the corner a lot. That's
he does. He stopped going for rebounds like that. He be standing in the corner.
He
just
be
a
trying
lot.
To shoot threes.
Yeah. I'm going to be real. You got to watch the game, though.
Carlos Stanton.
He ain't give me nothing.
Nothing.
Are you serious?
Giancarlo.
He, damn. He was DH today, but damn.
Yeah, four at-bats. Yeah,
no. He's
yeah, four at-bats?
Four at-bats.
Giancarlo Stanton, he's just a DH now over there. He's not playing outfield or nothing like that.
So I'm going to have to pick one for late night if this one with the... Oh, no, this one probably go for $105.
I almost hit on Call of Duty, though, but, you know.
Call of Duty. That
yeah, they got a Call of Duty where they got
Obi Toppin, dog.
I don't even swipe that far down on the list.
Yeah, I swipe far. I was like,
I only got
what?
The first three, and that's it.
Let me go ahead and try this Call of Duty. I just missed two people. Missed
COD.
That's it.
Man, we got
two people missed.
What's his name? Jeremiah.
Yeah, I gotta hit Jeremiah.
Link up with him.
Jeremiah be on that Twitch, bro. Y'all gotta watch him. He balling.
Yep.
He be balling. I'm like, okay. Oh, Tristan Thompson on that list. I just saw. You want Tristan Thompson?
Hell no.
I was about to say, you better not say
the
yeah,
Kardashian man. Curse. Man, go somewhere.
That nigga is terrible.
Go somewhere, man.
All right, so we got the Knicks, Indiana playing right now. What's the other games left? Oh, Minnesota and Timberwolves play tonight, right?
Mm-hmm.
And it's game seven.
Minnesota
and
who you?
Denver. Yeah.
Yeah, I said Minnesota and Timberwolves.
I'm going for Minnesota. Yeah. I'm going for Minnesota.
So Denver and Minnesota, who y'all got?
I'm going for Minnesota. I want Minnesota to win.
I want to see Ant do it.
Yeah.
Because I feel like
I want to see Ant get a ring, to be real. If my team ain't
for his story, it's perfect.
It is. And I feel like, I'm be honest with you, any team from that is going to beat Dallas to me.
I feel
except
like,
for Denver, just,
I feel like
it'd
be more interesting with
New York losing.
Minnesota.
Yeah, it'll be more interesting
with
Minnesota.
Interesting with them.
Yeah. You'll actually want to watch it because of Anthony
I don't
Edwards.
Like watching Denver play, I'm going to be honest with you.
Yeah.
I don't either.
Yeah. I don't like watching them either because I don't like watching them.
I don't like Mariano.
Yeah. Anthony Edwards is fun to watch him. So it'll be good to watch. That'll be a battle right there.
Oh, yeah.
Anthony Edwards about to blow by him too, though, all game. Like, if Luka get on him, he blow him by him.
Well, he not going to guard him.
And they're not going to look. They ain't going to try to get him on there. Yeah.
He could be PJ or Derrick Jones.
And I'll be real. They're going to have a... They could be
better
tough. Be ready.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, they better be ready for that
one. It ain't going to be easy at all.
It's not going to be easy to guard him.
Is Derrick Jones the ones that can jump pretty high?
Yeah, yeah, he can jump pretty high.
He need to be on him.
Because that's the only way he can get up, huh?
Dog. He get up.
Yeah.
Yeah, he know.
Man.
Derrick Jones. He was
that was a good ass series.
That was a good ass series. Though,
I'm not going.
Yeah,
that was,
man, he's got a Mavericks.
Y'all good though.
I'm going,
y'all gonna
I'm
be
going
back
for Minnesota. I'm going for whoever going against them.
Kyrie Irving
is
13-0 in closeout games.
Yeah.
That's what I knew. That's why I said we need a player like that.
Yeah.
That veteran like him because.
And that's the crazy thing is, though, bro. I rocks with Kyrie Irving so much. I want him to win something.
Absolutely.
I just don't. I'll be honest with you. Luka get on my nerves by
if
all
it's
that
him
crying.
Or I, I'm cool. I mean,
guess where Luka learned it from?
LeBron.
LeBron, that was his favorite player.
Yeah. Yeah. That's
LeBron true. Messed up so much.
That's true. Okay, my bad. My bad. I forgot. Yeah.
Hey, LeBron's the GOAT, guys. Stop it.
LeBron ain't my GOAT. I'm convinced, the LeBron James stuff got me like, I'm all the way Jordan now. I used to try to defend him. Like, man, but he.
You said Jordan?
Yeah, Jordan's my GOAT.
Oh, okay. That's cool.
Yeah, Jordan my GOAT.
That's cool. I mean,
straight up.
I can't debate it.
Who's your
Kobe GOAT? Second
Kobe.
On my list.
Kobe is your GOAT.
Kobe's mine easy.
Yeah, yeah, easy.
Kobe second on mine. LeBron not even third right now.
I've seen the Kobe. Like, not like, I ain't see like Jordan. I ain't really see Jordan, but I mean like, I remember the Kobe stuff, so that's why it's to me. That's the only reason to me.
When I was a kid, I had all the Jordan gear.
You did.
You know what I mean? I still got the picture from when I was 5 years old I got one.
I mean, you got Michael Jordan, everything.
Everything. Yeah, yeah. But Kobe is one of the greatest to ever do it. So that's why I put him second.
I hate that they don't
putting LeBron third.
That's what Shaq say all the time.
You know I mean? Hate that they don't put him in. That don't make no sense to me. He's the closest thing to, like y'all say, to Jordan.
I'm just saying.
And then y'all say, Jordan is the greatest. How is he not in the top three?
We saw him do what he did.
If he's not the best, how is he not in the top three? That makes no sense to me. If you never put Kobe Bryant in your top, that's ridiculous to me. It's like, I don't understand it.
I just want to say, for the people that have LeBron as their GOAT, if LeBron had a broken finger, do you think he went in the finals?
Nah.
That's what Kobe did.
Kobe was hurt.
On his shooting hand, a broken
now
finger.
We can't say,
and
though.
He switched over to the left and was shooting with the left.
We can't say that LeBron never had nothing broke. We might not know.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? He might not have said it was broke or nothing.
If we don't know, it didn't happen.
I mean, we did. Yeah, you knew about
that's true.
Kobe, yeah.
But I'm just saying, 20 some years, he's still not my GOAT, but I'm just saying. He did do some incredible stuff. Some stuff he did was incredible.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I loved watching it. I still watch these games now because it'd be more exciting, but it's just the Lakers.
He just messed up
the whole rotation.
He messed up his legacy too by the stuff he be doing. Like, if stuff don't go right,
it's the coach's fault.
The coaches,
players
the people
gotta get
around
switched
him
out.
Gotta switch.
Yeah.
It's like, okay, bro, but you wanted these people.
Kobe was the same
Stop
way.
Changing
though.
Teams.
Yeah.
It wasn't, I don't know if he got coaches fired, but he got players. He was like, yeah, I'm just can't.
He had a lot of coaches toward the end of his career.
You know what I mean? So
like after
Kobe?
Yeah.
I mean, because they didn't know what they was doing.
Was
though.
Bad.
You can see.
Mike D'Antoni was
not
a good coach for that team.
The thing is, Kobe, but he earned, and I get it. We can say LeBron earned it too. We had to do that. But I'm just like, the fact this is what I don't like though. You wanted these people. You the one
don't be mad
you
now.
Had a choice to bring all them here.
Yeah, don't be mad now. You do.
You see what I'm saying?
But he been making horrible decisions of people he wanted around him.
Yep.
J.R. Smith?
Yep. Yep.
I'm just saying.
So, but I hate that. That's what I hate. And I'll be like, bro, I like you, but you do some stuff sometimes. You throw people under the bus quick. Then it's like, what about you, bro? Okay, we get it. You wanted these people, though. Don't sit up here and be like, they don't want to listen to me now. The Lakers don't. No, you wanted these people. They gave you all sort of input with everything.
Yeah.
So don't sit up here now and want to change and be like, oh, yeah, they not doing this. They not doing that. I'm like, bro, you got the most. You could demand everything.
Yeah.
So let's not do that.
You got to just take it everything. On the chin. We lost.
Let's be real.
And
you're
don't
about
be
to get your
on,
son drafted.
Yeah.
You could demand everything.
Yeah.
So don't do that.
Don't get on the podium talking about. It's just basketball. It's just basketball. You was just mad. That killed me right there. I was like, I can't defend this dude no more. That's what did it right there. I was like, bruh, Jordan would have never said that. Jordan went in the locker room with a baseball bat and a cigar talking about, oh, yeah, they talking now. Let's see if they talking tomorrow.
Yeah, I know. That was,
nigga,
that was.
You went on the podium. It's just basketball. Smiling.
At the end of the day, it's just basketball.
Man.
That told me that y'all was gonna lose right
you
there.
You went out like a
that.
Hoe right there.
I told y'all before it happened.
You
wasn't about to do nothing.
I'm like, bruh.
I was trying to be optimistic after game one, be like, look, if we get game one, then we'll see.
Mm-hmm.
Man,
my GOAT would have never did that. Like I said, he went in there with a baseball bat. Nigga, this is a basketball locker room. He in there with a baseball bat and a cigar. Like, yeah, I'm about to step on him next game. Watch. And that's what he did. Stepped all over him.
He sure did.
Had them rethinking life. That. Rethinking if they was going to retire from basketball because he stepped on them. Bruh, you went on the podium. It's just basketball. That was the worst thing you could ever did.
Oh,
you can't be a GOAT. You can't be. I don't care how many you got the most points and all that. Nah. Bruh. You ain't got that dog in you. So, yeah. You can't be my GOAT.
Yeah. I mean, once you say that, you got to drop him, bro. I'm
yeah,
sorry.
You killed the whole, nobody ever whole said legacy that. With that right yeah, there.
Nobody bro. Ever said, none of the greats ever said, it's just a game.
Kobe didn't go on the podium. They asking him why he ain't smiling. He like, did we win yet? Is it over?
That's what I'm saying.
That's what I'm not smiling. I'm like, he in kill mode at the on the interview.
Yep.
He like, man, I can't wait till tomorrow. You, it's just basketball. Oh my God, bro. I hated that. It killed me, bro. I was like, Bron, you, I was defending you, bro.
Yeah, man.
You killed me, bro. You let me down with that one. I ain't gonna lie.
So in the East, though, who we got left in the East? It's New York and Indiana. Is anybody else?
And then it's
who else?
Who is left?
Boston.
Oh, that's right. They were waiting for Boston. Waiting.
Man, I hate.
So who y'all got winning that out of this one? Because if New York go, I'm
Boston
hoping
beating
New York
whoever
wins.
Get there.
You don't Boston think beating. You don't think New York got a chance?
Boston beating whoever getting there.
Damn.
Whoever they gotta got to go against.
Think
they got a chance.
I feel like New York got a chance.
They got a chance.
I don't think Indiana
Josh
got a chance.
If Josh Hart is hurt. And Brunson got to score 40 a game. They not winning, bro. He's so going to score 40.
Is Randall not coming back 50. The whole season?
Oh Randall not coming back? Oh, okay, yeah. It's raps, bro.
I still think they got a chance. They played pretty good together.
Yeah.
And I think.
You got Jason Tatum. What's the other one?
Jaylen Brown.
Jaylen Brown. Derek White. Who else is on the team?
Drew Holiday, Al Horford.
Drew Holiday. Just them four. That's going to be hard, bro.
I get it, but they do got.
What's his name supposed to be coming back for this next series?
Porzingis supposed to come back after like.
Oh, okay.
Game two, damn. I think they said.
If he comes back, tough, bro. It's going to be tough. But, I mean, you still got DeVincenzo that could just have a crazy game at any time.
Yeah, but see, the reason they're even in this game, this series, is because Hart went off.
That's, yeah.
If he can't. Even shoot.
But he might get a little rest. If he can get a little rest. And be ready.
I don't know what's wrong with him, but.
If he can get a little rest and be ready for this next series.
Right now, he got 2 points.
Damn. That's going to be tough. And I don't want Indiana to win because I feel like Indiana don't got a chance at all. It's just.
Yeah, he's.
I don't like Miles Turner play. Miles Turner is a big.
It's Halliburton for me. Like, he don't shoot enough.
Yeah, he don't. Yeah. He don't. And he be making them.
Halliburton got a score.
He be making them and he don't want to shoot. I don't understand it.
It's wraps. Indiana up 43-27. It's wraps. It's only the second quarter.
43-27?
It's only the second quarter, but.
That's a lot of basketball.
45-27.
I don't like.
They up 18.
I hate the way Miles Turner play. But that one that they brought in, Pascal been balling for them.
Oh, Siakam, yeah.
Siakam? Yeah, he been balling. I'm be real. I don't think. They might have a chance then. They might have a chance against Boston. I really don't like the matchups on the East side, on the East. So
Indiana got a better chance than New York, I think, but I still think Boston for no.
But like you said, if Hartenstein don't be shooting, it ain't even got no chance.
Hartenstein got.
Not Hartenstein. If Indiana.
Halliburton.
Halliburton. If he don't shoot, it's.
Yeah.
It's a waste. And you've been hitting all this time.
And then Jason Tatum going to play defense on him, and it's going to be hard. Drew Holiday going to play defense on him. It's going to be hard.
Yeah.
Drew Holiday got some of the best defense for a guard. I'm going to be real.
Yeah.
Halliburton been balling all season, too. I don't know why he don't shoot. I don't get that. You be making your shots when you put it up, but then he stops shooting.
Yeah.
I don't see what he got right now.
So, we'll see.
Sheesh, man.
Yeah, I don't like we'll see, man.
I was trying to watch these motherfucking Yankees.
Full of crazy. I'm so disappointed in the Yankees.
Dude, I kind of told y'all, bro. The Yankees, bro.
It was all they had to get was two bases.
I know, bro. You got to watch them.
Two hits or a
double. Halliburton got 14 points right now.
Oh, okay. So he's scoring right now. Yeah. He's scoring.
He's shooting the ball.
He going on.
Yeah. So that's why they winning right now.
Yeah, because he normally finishing the game with 17 points.
Yeah. He didn't do it last game.
Man. Dang, he didn't do it last game? Oh my God. What he in
the game? He started shooting like in the fourth quarter, but.
Oh my God. Yeah, that's
he what wasn't he shooting before.
He, and when he played Boston, you can't do that.
Ariel Atkins got 12. She got to get 17.
12 points?
Yeah, but
what quarter is it?
I can't tell.
Man, she be stopping though.
I can't tell what quarter it is, but it's been on for about an hour, so it's probably halftime.
Yeah, Ariel Atkins, she gotta, you gotta keep Where's going.
Where's OG Anunoby? I need him to get 3 rebounds.
Oh well, he was hurt, so
damn.
He
might not play.
Oh, he
might come back for this game.
Yeah,
they said he played.
He played.
Oh yeah,
he might not.
I mean, he was gonna be tough to get rebounds. I thought he hurt his like hamstring or something.
Yeah, he on limited minutes.
Yeah. Cause he got a fast break and he grabbed his hamstring and had to get hurt
easily right now.
Yeah.
Okay.
So,
but since we on sports, I wanted to talk to y'all about. I just want to make our predictions early. Cause I just saw that the Jets got like 6 primetime games this next year because
it's
got
Aaron Rodgers back.
Yeah, because they got Aaron Rodgers back.
Well, he's gonna be back for the season.
Yeah, but what's y'all prediction for who y'all got winning championship next year?
The Jets? What you mean?
For real though, seriously. Serious question. Let's.
I'm being dead serious.
You know, there's no way you're being serious. There's no way you being serious about
I'm
that
being
one.
Dead serious. The Jets like, get it, bruh.
Bruh.
I'm not no Raider fan. I'm not like them Raider fans.
Okay, I'm gonna be serious.
Jets winning.
Let me be serious. Archie, okay, you be.
Who you got?
I'm gonna be real. Because I'm breaking it down because. Buffalo messed up to me. I feel like they destroyed their chance to even beat Kansas City now. And you got rid of your receiver.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, bruh, I don't know what y'all
doing. So you saying KC getting back there?
Okay, let's do this. Who y'all think going to be in a Super Bowl?
That shit tough to...
I got to look it up.
And I know we ain't... Yeah, I know we ain't really...
I don't know.
Looked at it. But just off of, like, let's just make a little prediction. Then to get closer to the season, we'll make another prediction.
I got the Houston Texans taking it.
Who do Houston Texans? Who they got?
I mean, they got that quarterback and they got
CJ Stroud.
What's the receiver they picked up? Dang, they picked up 2 receivers, I thought, at the draft. Right? It was 2 solid receivers, too.
I don't know who these niggas got. I just got them. I just got them winning it.
You got them winning it? Okay, you go go out. Okay, okay. I guess, Vince, you cool then. You can say James. I'm going to say...
in the NFC?
I'm going to say... who got in the NFC?
It's tough. I got Niners.
That's all. But I was just about to say, I think Niners going to get there this year.
NFC finally. Niners. AFC.
Get where?
They going to get to the Super Bowl for sure.
They've been getting there.
And they keep losing.
Yeah.
They going to get back there again this year.
In the NFC, I don't see who can really get with them like that.
The Niners?
The Eagles?
Oh, the Eagles in NFC? That could be.
Wait. Did the Saints get another quarterback? Did they clean house? I got to go look.
Get another quarterback, you said?
Yeah, I thought they got a...
We'll do more deep dive into it
when
the season get closer. But I'm going to say Niners and...
Jets. No, I'm playing with you. it's going to be KC probably again.
It's Houston on the...
Or Baltimore.
AFC.
Or Miami.
In Miami. I'm going to say Miami.
I'm going Bengals in the AFC.
Oh, yeah.
Bengals, AFC.
I'm going Bengals.
Niners, NFC.
Bengals, yeah. That's what I'm going. Bengals, Niners. Bengals had picked up. All them dudes played with each other now.
Bengals, Niners.
They basically pulled New York Knicks. All them dudes playing together.
Yep.
In Bengals, college. Niners. And now they in the NFL together. So I'm going to go with them. I'm going with the Bengals. That's just our take until the season start coming more into full effect.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me?
That's our pre-season.
Yeah. Now, once the preseason starts and we get to see players and stuff like that, we'll give you more of a deep dive into it. But shout out to the WNBA because
they doing
it's actually,
It's entertaining.
I'm watching it. Yeah, I'm watching it. So
I've been watching it every day.
Yeah.
I'm going to go in there and watch
every game I've been turning on. So shout out to them for sure.
Y'all got any other topics out there that we missed, that we just forgot to hit?
Man, I think that's good. I think that's it. I'm trying to think.
What's the time?
How much time?
Minute 34. I mean, hour 34. I don't know why I keep saying
that. Yeah, that's good. Man. Well, before we go. I didn't know he was talking about DeMar DeRozan. Another line of walking. And I'ma send it up to Pop. And I won't pass the ox. Yes, sir. And that was episode 6 of the Baller Up Culture Podcast. We'll see y'all.
Archie, what's the title? I just want to guess the title right now. What'd you say?
Damn. I ain't even got nothing right now.
Better right now?
Kendrick Lamar stepped on Drake. No, I'm saying. All right, y'all. We out.